Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. And yeah, I think there's only one way to go, and it's this way. And we're coming across stronger things and undead things and traps. So I don't know if you could possibly.
Gotcha.
Locate any others. We should get a good description of these weird pillars, columns.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Now you see me? Good to go.
Could have gone worse. Protection from electricity, he has. And leaving shadows. So she failed. She failed twice. Get back in the shadows. I can't even put her back
don't
in.
Want my sword,
oh.
Cannibal.
That's him.
I won't be as gentle.
What do you want?
Wrong person.
Most unpleasant memories.
Yeah, most unpleasant memories. I get it. You've told us all about your unpleasant memories. I actually wonder, do I have anything in my potion bag that is good for thievy types? What ice dust does again? Oh. Protects all within area from fire damage. Let's see, give her those. That's really it. You know, she could use a couple of these, these. Making sure the rest of us have that as well. Oh, and shield? She can learn shield? I don't know when I picked that up. Okay. And right, I put that there. And you have Book of Infinite Spells. Okay. So I was gonna have her take one.
Right you are.
Can't walk over there. Okay, we've got some chests. An imp says, "Who? Someone has come to play at last." Another imp says, "Yes, yes, yes, someone will play with us now. And not that stodgy, overgrown fish king." Yeah, that old fish king. Woo! No sense of humor. None. But now, Hehe, you big peoples will want the treasure, right? Big peoples always want the drow's treasures, yes. You can have the drow treasure, oh yes, but you have to play our game first. Hehe, you have to play our game. What say you, big people? You are wanting the treasure? You wants to plays our game, yes? Yeah, they could see through invisibility, apparently. Unless it's just a scripted thing. Why would I want to play this game? What's to stop me from taking the treasure myself? Tee-hee! Well, you could go and look in all the chests if you wanted to. Yes, yes, you could! Hee-hee! Most of them are empty now, anyway. Most of them, all except for one. One of them is locked up tight and has all of the drow's treasure. All of it. Somehow I doubt that. And something else, too. Sekula's... whatever. It has a nasty, nasty, nasty inside it that will come out and steal your soul. You'll be forever dead, dead. Hee hee, we can unlock the chest and protect you from the nasty, nasty, nasty Sekula's tooth. Yeah, that's what we're looking for. But only if you plays our game. It says that again. Very well, I'll play your game if that is what it takes. The big peoples will play our games. Or our game. Hooray, hooray! Okay, big peoples, this is how our game will go. There's 5 chests here with nothings in them. In front of each empty chest, a famous big people will appear. Famous big people. Oh yes, powerful famous big people. Each famous big people will give you a gift that belongs to another famous big people, and they will hint to you what gifts belong to them. If you thinks you knows which famous big people a gift belongs to, you puts it in the empty chest behind them, yes? Very simple. Once you places all 5, you comes and asks us. If you're wrong, we laugh at you. If you're right, we open the 6th chest and you can laugh at the nasty, nasty, nasty. Lots of fun. Okay, we starts now. What? Riddle of the Imps? A couple of imps indicated that one of the 6 chests here is locked and has something inside that will steal my soul unless they protect me from it. They will only do that if I solve their riddle. I have to match up the items from the illusionary figures... I have to match up the items that the illusionary figures give me to the ones they belong to, putting their item in a chest behind them. Then I have to go talk to the imps when I'm right, well, I assume they'll tell me. Okay. This is what we're looking for. Sekula's tooth, I assume, is in the last chest then. Elminster.
You point. I live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So far there were 2 chests down here. Failed to find either of them and got blasted twice. All right, everybody. Who's this? Kelvin. Oh, Kelvin Blackstaff. Last saw him in Eye of the Beholder 2. Drist? And 2 others. You can't outsmart an imp. You can't. You got something wrong, but I'm not telling what. I'm doing the thing yet. You got something wrong with the gifts. You did put them in the chests, right? Who else we have? Illustrial. Okay, I'm not familiar with that character. Fergirin, same, I don't know. And there's Drizzt. Of course I know Drizzt. And Elminster. And Kelvin. Well, this isn't the real Elminster.
Fine.
I can offer some guidance, but I will not interfere in your destiny.
I am Elminster. You know me, friend, as the oldest wizard to have walked the land. In my heart, I am but an old man, and I require an item to while away time's sand. Okay. An hourglass. I feel like... I have these post-its in front of me. I know you can't see, but... Hourglass. I'm just gonna write it. I give to you this curved sword. I am too old to fight. Give it to another warrior, one whose skin is black as night. Drizzt.
I can offer some guidance, but I will not interfere in your destiny.
That's good to know. Scimitar. Looks like this, though. This curved scimitar is light and appears well used. It shimmers slightly with a cool blue hue, and the sparse gems along its pommel sparkle with a pale light that makes it appear to be almost made of ice, a quality weapon. I don't know where that goes to. Goes to you. Well, not you. You. Oh! Save us a spell. Alright.
Alright.
Can you try to find some traps? Thank you.
No problem at all.
Well, I've got a lot of experience of finding these traps. So this one's triggered already. Well, there's two there. Brother. Okay, so there's the six. Okay, that's wonderful. There's a beholder there. Oh, boy. I don't even want to move. Not even backwards. Is there another one around here? Okay.
Menial
task. Yes, you have my attention.
I am Drizzt, a drow who left my hated home below to become a hero true. I require something with which I have vanquished many. One of two. I give you a helmet here, a symbol, so I'm told, of rulership on the surface land in a city far north and cold. Oh, Icewind Dale, perhaps? Got a helmet. This helmet is black and lustrous, its metal brought to a shine that nearly matches the small gems that have been placed around the faceplate. A black veil hangs down the open front of the helmet, obviously meant to completely obscure the face of whoever wears the item. These aren't enchanted, at least not in a traditional sense. At least that... See, this looks like a magnifying lens or something. Alright, well, at least this looks like a helmet.
This way, then?
I'm still having her hang around.
Gotcha.
Try to find some traps. Oh. She's invisible right now. I guess she's alright. Okay, so the helmet goes to someone from Icewind Dale, apparently. Maybe.
A den of stinking evil. Cover your nose, Boo. We will leave no crevice untouched.
Oh, I didn't mean to. Oh, we put in a chest, right? Okay.
Fine.
So I'll just put his in. I hope all the traps are gone. All right, Kelbin Blackstaff. I am Kelbin, a wizard of great power, one of the rulers of the finest city of the north. Waterdeep, right? I need the item that supplies my fondest name and an extra leg as I walk forth. I need the item... an extra leg. Oh! Staff. Black staff. This requires knowledge of the Forgotten Realms that, you know, I don't know if Kelbin's... I think maybe Kelbin would have mentioned once or twice in Baldur's Gate. That's really it. I mean, you don't run into him, at least not yet. I have not. I give to you this pendant of silver, for it belongs to another. Place it around the neck of one who is sister, but not mother. Well, I guess that would be this one. That's the only female there. This is a small and fairly unremarkable silver pendant in the shape of a miniature sword, hanging on a delicate chain and meant to be worn around the neck and next to the skin. Okay. Alright, so you want a staff. A black staff. And an hourglass for Elminster. And then I assume... he's one from Icewind Dale, or wherever the north they're talking about, and this is the one who is sister, but not mother.
Hello there.
Hello. I am Elustriel, a daughter of Mistra, one of seven. Lady of the Moon, give me my symbol of the sword bequeathed by my mother from her home in heaven. I give to you this pipe of root and magic. Its power is strong, I will not lie. Bequeath it to a man instead, one older than even I. Yeah, I'm getting lost now. Pipe. This is a dark and delicately crafted meerschaum pipe. Used for smoking particular roots and odorous plants. It appears to have been carved from Felsol root itself and smells faintly of brimstone and cinnamon. That's an odd combination. Brimstone and cinnamon. What? Oh, did her, I think her invisibility wore off. Is that what happened?
Ready and willing.
I swim in memories in such a place as this. Most unpleasant memories.
What happens if I could just go up and talk to this beholder?
Good to go.
Or she does. Visitors, it has been some time since I have had anyone but the mad little Sahuagin come to this place. And that one is not full of riveting conversation. Ah, but I see you hesitate. No doubt you have heard of my kind before, or even met some. You call us beholders. Yes, I think that is the term you use. I am but a spectator beholder, however, and not quite like the others you have met. I am set in this place to guard one thing and one thing only. I will not attack you, unless you try to touch what I guard. Touch nothing else. Touch anything else you'd like. Provided you weren't driven insane by the imps back there. What is it exactly that you guard? Just the one chest behind me. You are welcome to open others with the imps or do whatever else. I'm not here to do anything about them in the slightest. I think the Sahuagin looted the other chests long ago. They might have put some stuff of theirs around here, though, thinking I would scare off thieves. Oh, that reminds me. I promised that mad little Sahuagin that I would make an effort to scare off intruders. So, boo! And that's about as much effort as I'm willing to put into that. It's been a pretty lonely experience so far, you know? How did you end up here, anyway? I was summoned by a mad little drow who took over this part of the Sahuagin city a long time ago. This chest was extremely important to him, apparently. The Sahuagin were attacking, and he didn't want them to get the chest after he died, so poof, and I came attached to a 99-year contract. Only 40 years to go. I don't know how long beholders live. The drow wasn't much more entertaining than Sahuagin, really. He smelled better, though. I don't think I'll ever be able to stomach fish again. Ugh. To top it off, I got stuck with the drow's imps, too, which are bound here but kept teleporting away from the Sahuagin. I wish they would just go away. I mean, I can only play I Spy in Peekaboo so many times without getting tired of it, but not them, oh no, rotten impish bastards. Just how can you smell without a nose? What? You think I can't smell because I got the one big eye thing going? How much do you know about magic, anyway? You're almost as bad as those imps. Is there no way I can release you from your task? That's sweet. Short of death, there isn't any way to shorten the 40 years I have left, and I'm not eager to greet the beyond just yet. What's with those imps in the other room, anyway? Oh, they've been here since the drow who summoned me was slaughtered. 60 years with only two imps and a mad fish king for company. Is this hell? There's a chest in there that the Sahuagin put something valuable in. Always whispered the incantation to open it, though. Like I would care. The imps figured out the incantation. I suppose they told you if you didn't squish them on the spot. Not that I would be sad exactly to see them gone. So I saw an additional thing to ask about the chest. Not a clue. I wouldn't recommend touching it, though. I haven't had any real excitement in a long, long time, but I have no compulsion towards killing, you know. Are you sure I can't see what's inside the chest? Right? Yep. What? Are you in desperate need or something? You have a dying relative that desperately needs what's in this chest? Oh, I get it. You just have to have what's in this chest, right? Because if a beholder's guarding it, it has to be cool. It has to be cool. This is a real beholder. Keep in mind that the drow who summoned me was mad, but hey, who am I to judge, I suppose? I've been playing tic-tac-toe with a pair of imps for 60 years. Oh, in case you didn't hear an answer in that, no, you can't look at what's in the chest. The drow specifically summoned me to guard this chest. I've encountered a peculiar spectator beholder set to guard a particular chest for a lengthy time. He didn't seem malevolent, but if I want what's in that chest, I guess I'll have no chance but to fight him. Perhaps someone wiser might be able to talk him into helping us out, but I don't know. Someone wiser? Oh. Automatically thinking the wisdom hers is 11. So if Faconia would talk, or I.
Red as rain.
But I haven't talked to this guy yet, have I? Pergeron?
Hey ya.
I am Pergeron, a paladin of Tears Faith and the open lord of my northern land. If you will, place a symbol of my rule within my hand. I give to you this staff of darkest hue, which has faced many an evil foe. It is not mine, but I tell you now, it belongs to one I know. Right there. Oh, he gave it to her. Okay. This is a long staff made of thick, sturdy oak. It is crawling with a strange black radiance and feels quite warm and tingly to the touch. Small runes of arcane origin have been carved in various places at both ends. Okay.
Something right you are.
Righto. Yeah, she's visible now, so. Alright, so we've got.
Faster than chick. Take a fast pause. Time to move?
So what does he need again? Because now we have everything.
Alright, alright.
It requires an item to while away time sand, which I figured would be an hourglass. A pipe? I mean, I don't know that much about Elminster. Maybe there's a special amulet, a pendant that he always wears that stops, it slows his aging or something? I don't know. I know we've got Kelvin's staff and Drizzt's sword, right? There's a sword in here. Yes. Whose thing is this then? Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, okay. I thought this was the sixth. I didn't bother counting them. I thought this was the sixth chest. So they're telling me 5 chests and then I can open the sixth. Unless they protect me from it. Sure, I can't just open it, yep. Right?
No problem at all.
I picked the lock. I don't think I should open it, though.
What, you can count on me?
At least not yet. Right? Like, maybe the imps will help us defeat whatever's in that chest? A lot of sounds going on here.
Such menial tasks.
The symbol of the sword bequeathed by my mother from her home in heaven. Maybe she gets the scimitar. What do you need? I require something with which I have vanquished many, one of two. Yeah, doesn't he have these two scimitars? So she needs a symbol of the sword. So the symbol of the sword is going to be a pendant, a helmet, or a pipe. I don't know enough about this. And what does this guy need? Place a symbol of my rule within my hand. I don't know what the symbol of his rule is. So maybe... Elminster... Right, okay. He smokes a pipe, I believe, yeah. So give him that pipe. So let's see if it makes a crazy noise. Crazy noise. Okay, so a helmet and a pendant. Hey, there it goes.
Hey.
A symbol of my rule. Which maybe is a helmet? There's that noise again. A symbol of the sword. This is an amulet. I could see Mistra having a, like a pendant amulet kind of thing. Let me see. Because there were other hints given, I think. Okay, the helmet is rulership on the surface land in the city far north and cold. So I'm guessing the helmet is for this Perjuran guy. Cursed sword, yes, for him.
This place is just too darn creepy. I really want out of here.
You're like resetting my log here. Right, okay. The pipe of root and magic. Its power is strong. Bequeath it to a man instead, one older than even I. Okay. Oh, Mistress pretty old, so... Kelbin. Okay, I give you this pendant of silver, for it belongs to another. Place around the neck of his sister, but not mother. Oh, she's a daughter. And I guess a sister. A sister to the other seven. Alright, so the pendant goes for Illustrial then. Now, before we... put the last thing in, which we might have to talk to the imps after that anyway, but let's get our skeletons going.
Yes.
Yes. I mean, who knows if it even appears here, right in the chest? Or in front of the chest?
Stand back! For
is
justice!
Jacques' trust is for the foolish and the dead.
I'll do it. A simple matter.
I don't want to talk to that. Alright, do we have... Alright, we should get some protection from evil going. So I had that on already.
Stories amongst my people. Potentus. Being underground is just not for the Abari.
Well, it's been for you for a while. Ace. Okay.
What? Fine.
So he gets the helmet. I don't know what's gonna happen, guys. I'm just being ultra cautious here. Ooh, you got it all right. You did. You outsmarted us, but good. The imp says. Aw, is the game's over already? Okay, okay. We keeps the deal. You goes and open the last chest now, and we imps will save you. We gets to laugh at the nasty, nasty, nasty. Oh, goody. Goes and opens it, big people. Huh. Oh. I didn't open it. Apparently I've solved the imp's riddle correctly and may now open the 6 chests while they protect me from whatever is inside. And there's a specter. It goes, aha! You have released me. But what is this? I cannot reach your life force. Ha ha. Poor nasty, nasty, nasty. The indignity. You can't do anything, nasty. We protect things to big people. No, no. I am too weak. Ha ha. That was fun. You funny big peoples. We go now. Their dimension dooring out. Wait, hold on a second. It's back in there? It's a done quest, maybe? Yeah, that was a thing. The imps were true to their word and protect me from the specter that laid inside the chest. The specter disappeared and the imps, having had their fun, did the same. I don't know if I've fought a specter before in Baldur's Gate. Just reviewing these really quick. Yeah. Okay. We got plenty of experience points for that.
Gotcha.
So now we look in and there's some magical boots and a cloak. Nice. Boots of etherealness. Why these boots were ever made has long been the subject of speculation among the sages of Candlekeep. Some suggest that a certain noblewoman was gifted them by an ethereal lover so that she could join him for a tryst. Others simply point out that the boots are useful for any mage to become intangible to attacks while devastating an opponent with offensive magic. Yeah, that sounds great. Etherealness once per day. Wearer is immune to normal weapons. Spells may still be cast and weapons may still be used. To normal weapons, but I guess not magical weapons. Right? Does this mean there's only one charge on them? Who are we fighting that just uses normal weapons? Besides the Sohuagin and the rebels, I guess. Unidentified cloak.